My name is Felicity Parker, and I am a breast cancer survivor.
Okay.
I was diagnosed on the 19th of May 2011. I had a lumpectomy on the 20th of June, and they removed the cancer, and they removed 6 lymph nodes as well, just to make sure that it hadn't gone to my lymph nodes. And my margins were clear and my lymph were clear.
And how did that experience affect the way you are today?
Oh my gosh, it's totally transformed my life. It's totally transformed the way that I live my life, the person that I am, the woman that I inspire to be. It's made me much more aware of who I am and who other people are and what they may be going through. So yeah, it's completely turned my life around. I'm very thankful for my experience.
When I tell people my scar story,
they ask questions. They're intrigued. Some people cry. Some people are really quite interested in the story, because I think as a society we've all been touched by cancer in one way or the other. So people are always interested to know what you've done and how you cope with it, because they can relate to that. Everyone can relate to a cancer story, I think. Everybody has a story to share. And I have a lot of people that are diagnosed. I do get quite a few phone calls from people asking, you know, what I did and how I did it, and how the journey that they've decided to take, the treatments that they're planning to do. And so it's really cool to have those conversations with people. So yeah, people definitely will open up and tell stories.
You said before you felt grateful. That were your words about your cancer, grateful.
Yes.
Can you explain why?
I was in a very emotionally abusive marriage, and through breast cancer I've learned that I'm in the driver's seat of my life, and that I can't give anyone the power anymore. So through breast cancer I have learned to live and not just survive. And so for that, I'm very grateful. I feel my scar more than I see it, because it is under my arm, so it's not something that I generally look at. But sometimes when I put my hand up and I see the hole, it can be quite confronting, because I forget. But if I have anything happen emotionally, I actually feel that. If I have negative emotions, I can often feel that in my breast. And because of the removal of the lymph nodes, my right armpit doesn't sweat. But if something emotional happens and I'm experiencing extreme joy or extreme sadness, my right armpit will run with water. It's really quite interesting. The emotional scarring that's been the hardest to overcome. The physical scars, the scars that you can see on the outside, I'm not going to say it was easy, but there was a process to get over that, and I followed a process. The emotional scars have been a lot harder, because I'm the only one that has my thoughts and I'm with them 24/7. So through emotional abuse from my ex-husband and my own lack of self-esteem and self-worth growing up, I have experienced, the emotional scars have probably created some of the physical scars, and now the physical scars are helping to heal the emotional scars. Yeah, I love hearing people's stories, because we all have a story. Everybody has a story. So I love, and some people have some really interesting stories around their scars, so I love to sit and listen and listen to where they go with it, because I mean, so many of us, we might think our scar is insignificant, but it's not. You know, it's created. You know, it's created a story. You know, someone might be telling us a story of a scar from being an 8-year-old, and they remember that vividly. You know, and that's part of their story. And you know, like, I mean, that's part of getting to know each other as humans.
And you also have some scars around your uterus.
Yes.
Or, you know, around that area. Can you tell us about those marks and how you got them?
Yeah. I had a uterine fibroid, which had grown to 15 centimetres and had eventually caused me to be incontinent. So I really needed to take care of that. You know, it's not a cool thing to be 40 and incontinent. So I had them removed, and they had to reconstruct my uterus. So I do have a scar that looks like a cesarean scar from that. So it was a 3-hour operation, and but I still have a uterus, so I'm really happy about that. My doctor wanted to do a full hysterectomy, and because of my age and the fact that I still wanted to have children, I asked him not to do that, to try and save it as much as he could, which he did, and he's done an amazing job. But he did say that he couldn't guarantee that I could carry a baby full term, so, and that I would definitely need to have a cesarean, that I couldn't ever give a normal birth. So that was 2 years ago that I had that surgery done, and we'll see if we have babies or not. Scars are they're a growing point, you know, they're a full stop in our life, where from that we can grow and we learn resilience and we learn strength and we learn that even though we've got a scar, that we're going to be okay. You know, that we can carry on, and maybe because of the scar, things can be a whole lot better than that they ever were. So, you know, because all scars, like if we have a scar, then it hurt, right? Same with the emotional scar, it hurt. So from there, we can only grow, and we can only learn that we're resilient and we're stronger than we ever thought we were. I used to tell the stories with tears and sadness, and even though I still get emotional about it, I can tell the stories with joy and with strength and with a knowing that that my scars are for a purpose, and that my purpose is to encourage and inspire, and you know, like, I mean, to tell those stories to other people so that they can open up and tell their stories. It changed me spiritually. It completely turned my spiritual life around. I remember the feeling before I went into surgery, and I had a lady that would come and pray with me, and I can still vividly remember being held in this amazing arms and knowing that I was going to be okay, you know, whatever that meant at that time. I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know whether I was going to be healthy or, you know, but I just knew that everything was going to be okay. So for me, yes, cancer has turned me around spiritually. And once again, thankful for that, because, you know, like, I now walk a spiritual path, that I am connected, and you know, and I'm and it keeps evolving, like it just keeps on coming forth when I'm ready for it keeps coming. And just, you know, I'm learning to surf now, you know, and through that I'm getting more and more spiritual awareness, and it's amazing. Yeah, it's beautiful. And I believe that the mother is the earth and the father is our heavenly father, and together, like, I mean, and we're all spiritual beings having a human experience. you know, and that's what we're here for. We're here to support one another and love one another, and there's no judgment. There should never be any judgment. It doesn't matter what someone looks like, or, and even sometimes what people say, it's because of a scar. It's because of something that's happening within them. So, yeah.
And what would you say to women who, or men, you know, about their scarring, or about any part of their body that they're hiding, or, you know, not embracing as much as you know, they could?
Mm. What would I say to them? I would say to them to just take some time and to really sit and just really feel who they are within, because what we see on the outside, it's just a house, and it houses so much more than what we can ever imagine. We have an incredible spirit within us, and everybody's body is beautiful. It doesn't have to look one way. It doesn't have to fit into any particular size or shape. You know, like I encourage everybody to show their body, and to show not necessarily just their body, but to show who they are. You know, like, I mean, find their magic within them, and let that shine out, and then the physical appearance doesn't seem to matter as much. When you can find that wonder inside of you, that spirit, that magic inside of you, then, you know, it is what it is. You know, like, we are who we are, and we're all beautiful. So, yeah, I encourage everyone, get out there and show it. And it doesn't matter if you feel like you look silly, it doesn't matter. There's been so many times when I've thought, oh my gosh, you know, like, I look silly or I feel silly, but it's okay, because you might just inspire someone, and that's a really cool feeling.
Is that advice you would have liked to have had when you were younger?
Totally, 100%. Yeah, because I did. I grew up thinking I was fat and I was ugly, and, you know, and I had an ex-husband that told me that I was fat and I was ugly and I was never going to make it, and, you know. So it's only been recently that I have embraced that I can look in the mirror and I can see beauty because of the spirit that lives in me. And I can see that in everybody. You know, you just have to look into somebody's eyes and you can see that they're an incredible person. So
thank you, Felicity.
Thank you.